Thank you. chapter 7, beginning at verse 15. We are in part 2 of the Renewed Mind series. This is such a blessing given today. And I think God is trying to really do some things in our individual life. And He is taking us to another level, another step. And it starts with us. Amen. A renewal of the mind, how we're thinking, how we're perceiving things. Are we putting God first? Are we putting His thoughts first? Or are we just abiding in what the world says is acceptable? Amen. Romans chapter 7, beginning at verse 15, and it reads, "For what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I will to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate to do, that I do. If then I do what I will not to do, I agree with the law that it is good. But now it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells in me." Verse 18. "For I know that in me, that is, in my flesh, nothing good dwells. For to will is present with me, but how to perform what is good I do not find. For the good that I will to do, I do not do. But the evil I will not to do, that I practice. Now, if I do what I will not to do, it is no longer I who do it, but the sin that dwells in me." Let us pray. Father God, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity to hear from you. Father God, we ask right now that every person under the sound of my voice, that you would just give them ears to hear and a heart to receive what you are saying today. Father God, I ask that the presence of the Holy Spirit increase in me, and that I decrease in the answer, Father God, so that your word shall go forth in truth, in power, and in clarity. In Jesus' name, pray in your name. Amen. Amen. Turn to somebody and say, "It's up to me." It's up to me. That's what God gave me. He said, "You know what? You won't change." And you keep blaming your circumstances and your situations, and you want to do it, but you just can't do it. But it's up to you when you decide, "I am going to do it because I will to do it, because I know my Father can equip me to be able to do it. So now I'm going to take responsibility and I'm going to say, you know what? It's up to me. This is my life. Amen. It's my choices that I can no longer blame anyone else but me. And so when I decide that I want to change, that change has to come when I decide, when I say it's up to me to make this change." Amen. We see here, he said, upon the sand, "For what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I will to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate to do, that I do." Amen. That's so familiar. I know that hit home with me, because as I was trying to do the right thing, I had a desire to do the right thing, but for some reason, I just could not do it. Amen. I wanted to do it, but then when the opportunity came for me to act on what I wanted to do, I didn't follow through. Amen. So it was something in the inside, amen, that was warring. Amen. Because the desire was there. I said it, that I wanted it, and I really did want it. But when the time came for me to do it, I didn't do it. Amen. And I had to realize that was a choice that I made. Amen. I had to realize that it might not be easy to do it, but that I had to be declare that I'm going to do it no matter what. Amen. And so realizing that it was the flesh, amen, the natural part of me, the part that's been doing what it wanted to do all the time, that was rising up, amen, because it's so easy to rise up, because that's what we've always been operating in. Amen. We were born into sin. Amen. So it's nothing that we have to strive toward holiness. We have to strive toward giving to the Spirit, because we're often led by the flesh, because that's the natural thing that we have always been doing. And so we have to know that we have to overcome this sinful nature in us. It's something that we have to take serious. We got to think, we have got a sinful nature in us. I want to do good. I am a good person, I think, but there is something that's warring against my spirit. Amen. This flesh keeps rising up, but it's up to me to calm this flesh. It's up to me to overcome this sinful nature. Not on my own, but oh God, I have some help. Amen. How many of y'all got some help? Amen. You gotta realize that you are not in this alone. You have some help. You have the Holy Spirit with you. But it's up to you to get connected. It's up to you to seek the power and the strength of the Holy Spirit to carry you through, so that you can follow through this time, so it can go a step further than saying, I want to do it, until you actually doing it. Amen. You can get there, but it's up to you. Amen. Claire, it's up to me.
It's up to me.
Amen. So we have to do more than just wish and hope to be a better person. Amen. We got to take steps to become that better person. It's okay to declare, and I hope, and I wish I could do this, and I wish and I hope for a better, but it is up to us to take steps to be that better person. And I believe part of those steps that we must take is taking our relationship with God seriously, putting Him right and foremost in our life. When we start off our day with God, amen, and start hearing from God early in the morning before we get outside that door, we are a little better prepared for what's to come, amen. So that's a step that we can take, establishing our relationship with God, taking time out for God, to hear from God early in the morning, because we don't know what the day holds. Because I wake up in the morning, I say I'm going to have a great day, an awesome day, but when I step outside my door, I'm not in control of what's going to happen. I'm not going to be in control of what I'm going to encounter, and so I need a little help to get me through the day. I need to be strengthened early in the morning. I need to hear from God, because I will to do a good thing today, God. I will not to sin. I will not to be disobedient, but I don't know what I'm going to face when I walk out my door. So Holy Spirit, I need you to walk with me. I need you to talk with me. We've got to take action, so we can't just hope for a great day, hope to be a better person. We've got to take steps to get there. Amen. We've got to take steps to be that better person, and we've got to make sure that we're taking those steps with God, with the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so we've got to seek help from God. It's okay to seek counsel from other people, but we need to seek help from God first and foremost in all that we do. That's the way that we're going to be able to overcome this sinful nature, to say, you know what? What I'm doing, I don't understand this thing. And then God's going to start opening our ears and opening our eyes and helping us to see us a little better, because I needed to get the blindness out, because I can see you. And I can see all that you were doing, but when it came to myself, it was a little cloudy. I was seeing clearly because I was overlooking some things, because, you know, that really ain't that bad until God had to show me, oh, yes, it is. If it go against what my commands are, if it go against my principle and my law, oh, it's bad. We're not sweeping that under the rug. You're not going to sweep your stuff up under the rug and worry about somebody else. And so it was up to me to look at me, to God to have me to say, you know what, you got to do some work on you. We've got to take these steps seriously. We got to look at ourselves with a clear mirror and say, God, here I am. All of me, I need you to do a new thing in me. I want this. And so, God, I need your help in getting all that you have for me. So we've got to seek help from God to overcome this sinful nature that we were born into. Amen. But we know that we can. So we must get in tune with the Holy Spirit that would enable us to rise above this old sinful nature. The Holy Spirit can get you to rise above. Amen. You will not be overcome by the flesh forever. You got to declare, I will not be overcome by the flesh forever. I can do it and I will do it because the Holy Spirit will enable me to do it. So getting in tune, getting connected, personal relationship, amen. So you hear the voice of the Holy Spirit because you're used to communion with him. And so you understand and you recognize when it's the Holy Spirit speaking to you. And so you yield to that, amen, to help us to overcome. But we've got to make that choice to say, I want to overcome. You've got to want to do it. No one can want it for you. We've all been praying for somebody or wanting something for somebody else, but it just wouldn't do it. It wasn't up to us. They had to make the choice. So we all have to make the choice on our own to overcome. If you're really tired or you really ready for it, just declare, I want to overcome. Amen. Make that choice and then start making the steps to overcome. We can do it and we will do it. But who is it up to? It's up to us. Amen. It's up to us to make that. So we've got to continuously study our Word of God. Get in us. We got to feed each and every day on the Word of God so that we know the truth and we can live more easily by its laws and principles because we're steady taking them in, daily doses of it. We're getting in the true and living Word within our hearts and within our minds, and then therefore we're able to operate in them. And so we're getting connected to the Holy Spirit. We're developing our relationship with God, and we're studying the Word of God. Those are all useful steps with helping us to overcome this sinful nature. Amen. But you got to be willing to do it. So we've got to make the choice to overcome our sinful nature. And one of the things that we must do, one of our steps, point one, control your desires. Amen. God truly does want us to enjoy our lives. Amen. That's why he gave us our physical senses. Amen. Our capacity. We can plan. We can reason. We can enjoy the thrills of life. Amen. However, if we do not control our desires, but instead allow our physical senses and emotions to run unchecked, then we are in danger to giving in to our sinful nature. Amen. So we got to enjoy our life, but we've got to live a balanced and moderate life. Amen. We've got to control our desires. Romans 8:5-8 tells us, for those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. For the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God, for it does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot. Those who are in the flesh cannot please God. Therefore, in order to us to continue to control our desires, we must set our mind on the things of the Spirit, things that are pleasing to the Spirit and not to the flesh. When we're living a life that's trying to seek to please God rather than just to seek to please our flesh and others and what we want to do all the time, that's what I'm saying. When you put God first in your life, then your desires will start going towards those things. I want to make God happy today. I want to do something that's pleasing to God. I want to draw somebody to Jesus Christ. I want them to know about God. Those things become more important in our life, and then our desires start going towards those types of things, things that are pleasing, that are acceptable to God. We know that pleasing the flesh is temporary, but when we seek to please the Spirit, you will be filled with a joy, amen, within that won't disappear. Because the temporary things, when we seek things of the world, those things are temporary, amen. The money may run out, the drinks may run out, the people are even going to run out on you. But when you are filled with the Spirit, when you are solid and filled with God, you can declare that the joy of the Lord is my strength. I'm not seeking things outside of my control. I'm seeking God first. I'm being filled with His Spirit, and therefore those voids in my life are filled. I'm not seeking the desires of this earth anymore. I realize that I'm just passing through, that it's just a temporary place here, and so I'm going to do the best that I can do on this side, because I realize that I'm going somewhere else. I'm seeking, I'm striving to get to God. I'm seeking and striving to get to my heavenly home. I'm seeking and striving to do good on this side so I can make it to the other side. We've got to make a choice and say it's up to me to make it to the other side. I realize that if I don't live right on this side, or I ain't going to the other side, amen. I'm going somewhere, but it's not.
Has overtaken you except such as is common.
way of escape you, that you may be able to bear it. Amen? So it didn't say that the temptation wouldn't come. But it's up to us to decide to take the way of escape. Amen. We got to want to take the way of escape. Because a lot of times we have noticed the way of escape to get up out of this situation. We feel our natural, our nature rising up. Amen. To do something that is conflicting with our spirit. And instead of getting ourselves out of there, amen, we stay a little longer because it's starting to be a little bit pleasing. But God says he will not tempt us beyond what we are able. And so when you start getting that little inkling, okay, you know, it's time to go. It's time for me to do something different. That's when we got to flee. Amen. We've got to take the way of escape. Amen. That we will be able to bear, because we can't expect to sit in the midst of it declaring, oh, we strong enough. Oh, I can do it. Well, you know, deep down, you ain't going to do it. Amen. Because honestly, you don't really want to do it. So you saying, God, I'm still having a little work done on me. I know you're still working on me. So I know I kind of actually want to do it, but I really don't want to do it anymore. Amen. That's what we got to be honest and say, you know what, God, give me the sense to hear from you that I can just remove myself from the things that are not for me. Remove myself from the things that are going to take me away from your word. Take me away from where I'm trying to go. And so we've got to learn to take the way of escape so that we can bear it. So the temptation, yes, it will come, but we need to flee from it. We can take the way of escape. We've got the Holy Spirit right there talking to us and telling us, leading, guiding, and directing us, but are we willing to listen to him? It's up to us to start listening. Amen. Can't say they made us do it no more. If it wasn't for them, man, I would have been straight. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have slipped up this time. If it wasn't for you bringing all that up over here, we can say, you know what? When you show up, amen, I can say, God bless you and have a nice day, but not today. Amen. It's up to us. We got to make a choice and we got to be willing to do it. So bearing the urges is the only way to learn to weaken and endure. Amen. We have got to learn, amen, to say, you know what, things are going to come up, but I know what I desire, and I desire the things of God. And so anything that is not of God, of what he has for me, I've got to learn to resist it, amen. I got to stay the course. I can't give in this time and say, whoo, I gave in this time, but maybe I get through this time, and it won't come back. No, it's going to come back even more and more. The only way to stop it is to stop yielding to it, to not giving to it anymore. Giving it to sin will not stop the temptation, amen, or the sin. Jesus did not give it to temptation to overcome it, amen. He resisted it, amen. When the enemy came to him in his weakest day, he resisted him. He knew the truth. He knew the word. He was able to give back the truth. So that's why I said we have got to know the truth and have it in our hearts. And so when those things come to us, when we're presented with anything other than the true living word of God, we'll be able to have our heart and mind so fixed on Jesus that we can just call out on him and we can say, you know what, I'm going to stand the test this time. I'm going to do it. Amen. So I'm not giving it to the temptation because it will not help next time. That's what I used to think. I was like, how retarded is that? Amen. But I had to be real. It's like, man, if I just do it this time, I ain't got to worry about it no more. But then the next time came, and the next time came, and the next time came, and I kept giving in to it until I realized I needed some help. Amen. I needed some help from the Holy Spirit. I needed to have some wisdom to flee, to take that escape. Amen. Not to give in, not to do a thing, but God, give me the strength to not do it. Give me the strength to walk away from everything that is not of you, from everything that will not lead me to the life that I am seeking to live. Because a lot of times, we are hindering the work that God is doing in our lives because we're so connected to things, amen. We're so connected to the things that we know are no good for us, that we are trapped. And God is saying, I've got this right here, but you keep on turning around and keep on playing with that that's not for you anymore. It was a time and it was a season I was trying to grow you into the things that I have for you, but you keep holding on to what's behind. You keep holding on to what's pleasing your flesh, and I'm trying to connect you to what I have for you through the Spirit, but you're not hearing me. You're not listening to me. So we have got to say, God, I want you, I'm willing, I'm able, it's up to me. I'm going to make these hard choices, I'm going to make these hard decisions, starting here, starting now, and I know through the enablement of the Holy Spirit, I can do it, and I will do it, amen? So we've got to take the escape, amen, each and every time. So we're controlling our desires, we're starting to think on board the things of God, we're starting to fill ourselves with the Word of God, and then we're fleeing from those temptations, amen? So we got to know that enduring temptations bring happiness to the believers, amen? Enduring the temptations bring happiness to the believers. James 1:12 puts it like this. For blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial. For when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love him. Amen. It's saying, blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial. Amen. I want to get there one day and say, blessed am I. Amen. When the trial came, I remained steadfast. Amen. I wasn't flowing here and from anymore. I wasn't tipping and dipping anymore. Finally, once in my life, I had pride and I could say, you know what? I remained steadfast. Amen. Because my God is bigger. Amen. And so we know we're striving to receive that crown, because we're not worried about this temporary anymore. We're worried about what's eternal. That's what we're striving for. And so we know that enduring these temptations, just sticking it out, just fleeing, that's going to bring happiness. Amen. Because when we give in, though it may be a moment of satisfaction, right after that, amen. Won't the enemy beat you up right after, amen, and trick you into submitting to something that wasn't good, amen. And then right after it, they go to get, amen. They start beating you across the head with it. But those who remain steadfast, those who just endure, flee from it. That's where the true happiness comes in. You can do it, amen. You will do it. But it's up to you to make the choice to say, you know what? I'm going to strive for these things. Amen. And so we've got to remember to bring every thought into captivity. Our third point. First was controlling our desires, fleeing temptation. Now we've got to bring every thought into captivity. 2 Corinthians 10:5 tells us, casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Taking every thought, amen, we're renewing our mind, remember, so that we've got to take every thought into captivity, but that requires something from us, amen. That requires some discipline on our part, so we got to do it. We know what the Word says about it, amen, that casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. So now, we've got to be disciplined on our part. We've got to make sure we're taking every thought into captivity, bringing it into the obedience of Christ, amen. Not looking or running with those thoughts, amen. All loose, we thinking all kind of crazy things, amen. And not bring that thing into captivity. When those thoughts come, bring it immediately to captivity and speaking the Word. What does the Word say about it, amen? And it ain't even all, I realize it wasn't even for me all about quote scripture, you know, walking around and something come in my head and then I'm, you know, quote James 1:2. No, it was just knowing in my heart what God had said, amen. And so I just started dwelling on those things, even if it wasn't verbatim, when you got the Word of God in your heart, and you know what it's saying, you can just say, you know what? That's opposite of what my God said. No, amen. And so that's how we continue to bring things into captivity. We got to think on the good things that are pleasing, that are acceptable, holy unto God. Amen. And so we realize the things that are not, you know, good coming to our mind, we gotta say, no, we know where this thing goes. If I keep dwelling on this thing, if I don't take this thing right now to captivity and cast it back out, I know where this thing is gonna lead. Amen. And it's not gonna lead me to a good place. And so it's up to us to say, I'm gonna do like the word of God instructs me to do. I'm gonna take this thought into captivity and bring it to the obedience of Christ. Amen. So we need to guard the door of our minds. That's what we've been learning in this series, that we've got to make the choice to guard what goes into our mind. Amen. Like I said, the thought may come, but we gotta have a guard standing right there and say, you know what? Oh, this ain't good. So I'm casting that right back out. So what are we filling our minds with? That's when we got to get real with ourselves and say, what are we really doing? What are we really spending our time and thoughts on? We realize that the transformation, it takes place in our minds. And so it's up to us to start being serious about what we are thinking about, changing how we think, how we perceive things, amen, not gratifying the flesh anymore, but yielding unto Spirit, amen, and continuing to offer our bodies as a living sacrifice unto God. So it says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Romans 12:2. It's up to us, amen, to no longer conform to this world. Saying it's up to me to control my desires. It's up to me to flee from temptation. It's up to me to change what's going into my mind. It's up to me to really do the work that needs to be done. I'm striving to do a new thing. I'm striving to be this person, amen, for what I will to do. I do not practice, but God, I'm seeking to practice those things. So it's up to me to really take those steps. So we got to remember to bring those thoughts into captivity, even when we're in anger. I realized that it was okay, amen. It's okay to yield to the Spirit and stuff, but then when I'm angry, everything else needs to come out. So we've got to realize and say, no longer is an excuse when I'm aggravated or I'm mad to go off the deep end. Amen. I've got to honor God in my life each and every day. So that means when it's all sunshine, amen, and that means when all hell I'm broken, I still got to honor God. I still got to go by His laws and principles. Amen. I still don't get a pass and say, just this time, I got to give them a little piece of my mind this time because they need to know, no, I got to bring those thoughts unto captivity, amen. And then I got to say, what is the word of God saying? Even if I really don't want to hear, I got to say, God, I got to see what you are thinking about this thing. And so I learned to not react to things so quickly anymore. Sometimes it's best to just be silent and what? Please, just take the way of escape. Everything doesn't need to be addressed all the time. That's what I had to learn. Sometimes God is just saying, close your mouth. They ain't trying to hear. Nothing you trying to say now. You know what you're saying is the truth, but they ain't trying to listen to you right now. Amen. And so just close your mouth because you ain't going to do nothing but get mad. So one minute you telling them a Bible verse, but you done got mad because they not listening to you because God has told you to leave them alone. Now you want to cut them out. And then they say, I thought you was a Christian. You ain't talking about God now. God told you to leave it alone. They wasn't ready. Continue to pray for them, but take the way of escape. I got to leave you alone. Amen. So we got to do that. We got to realize that it's up to us, even when we're mad or angry. We got to continue hearing from God in the Spirit, letting Him direct us, knowing when to go and when to stand. Amen. So we've got to continue working on us. Not loving the world, but loving God more than the world. And we can continue to do this. And so, as the scriptures say, I'm going to read it again. I want y'all to really take heed to this, because it just really blessed my soul as I was really striving to do something different and really related to what it's saying when it says, For what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I will to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate to do, I do. If then I do what I will not to do, I agree with the law that is good. But now it is no longer I who do it, but the sin that dwells in me. Realizing that I had something wrong within me, that's why I couldn't do it. And so I needed to yield to the Spirit of God. I needed to take some steps to control my desires. I needed to take some steps to really guard the door of my mind to do something different. For verse 18 says, for I know that in me, that is my flesh, nothing good dwells. For to will is present with me, but how to perform what is good I do not find. For the good that I will to do, I do not do. But the evil I will not to do, that I practice. Now, if I do what I will not to do, it is no longer I who do it, but the sin who dwells in me. And so I've got to take some steps to do something different. If I don't want the same outcome, then it's up to me to make some different choices. God has given us each an opportunity, starting here, starting right now, to make some different choices. To do something different so you can get a different outcome. Are you ready? Amen. Are you willing to let God help you in this area? Amen. Declare and say, it's up to me.
It's up to me.
Amen. We're going to do it. I know that God is able. He is really teaching us something in this Renewed Mind series and just saying, I want more of you. I want you to take this thing seriously. I want you to take your relationship with me serious. God wants you to honor him. Put him first, and you'll see how smoother the walk gets. Amen. Just taking the time to simply say, God, here I am. Amen. Mold me, created me. Amen. I want to be molded into all that you have for me. God has some great things in store. Don't let anything hold you from those things any longer. It's time. Amen. So declare, it's up to me. It ain't nobody else. I'm not blaming people and realize, start pointing the finger at me. It's up to me. You can do it and you will do it. Amen. So I encourage y'all throughout the week, please go back and read. Amen. I hope you took notes and not see me afterwards, but really, God is trying to do something. And I believe that we won't no longer, everyone won't be saying, I do things that I don't want to do. God will be saying, you know what? Testifying to how good God is. Now I've overcome. Amen. My God is good because the sin that dwells in me is not stronger than the Spirit of God that lives in me. So I can do it. I will do it this time around. So be encouraged. Be blessed. Even when you have a little setback saying, oh, that was that time, but God, I know you're going to give me another opportunity and I'm going to get it right. Amen. Keep going forward and be blessed. Amen. Thank you.